If you just pick a random free antivirus and hope for the best, it's like protecting your house with a beware of the dog sign without actually having a dog. Our devices deserve better than a security system powered by hope and upgrade now ads. So today, let's talk about the differences between a free versus paid antivirus. When is a free antivirus software enough, and when should you consider investing in a premium option? Once you start searching for the best free antivirus, you'll see a ton of options out there. So be really careful with lesser known names and overblown protection promises. They are often just scams. That said, even some big industry names have some pretty crappy free antivirus versions. Take AVG, Avira, or Avast as just an example. They might deal with simple threats, but you'll be bombarded with upsell pop-ups or just have your PC resources drained. That is why I always recommend investing in a proper antivirus. I think peace of mind is worth the 20 bucks a year, sometimes even less depending on what provider you pick and whether you check the description for discounts. But more on that later. If you are determined not to pay or just not sure what the benefits are, don't worry, I got you. I'll share my most trusted free antivirus for PC, and then I'll show you what you can get if you decide to upgrade. So without further ado, my favorite free antivirus option is, drumroll please, Bitdefender. It has a very stellar reputation and a strong malware detection record. And while their free version is a mere whisper of what the full package can do, it's still one of the best options you can get. It effectively scans for threats and even lets you use real-time protection, which watches over your device 24/7. It's also light on system resources, so it will run silently in the background and fit even older and less powerful PCs. Now, this might be a personal preference, but I really like their interface. It's clean, straightforward, and easy to get used to. Plus, you don't get bombarded with ads or upselling prompts. However, keep in mind that the free version is Windows only. You won't be able to get it as a free antivirus for Android, iOS, or Mac. All right, there is actually a free Mac version on the App Store, but it is very bad. Basically just a buggy scanner, so I don't recommend it. And on top of that, with the free Windows app, most of the additional features will be locked behind a paywall. There's no firewall to protect your network traffic, no anti-ransomware backup tools, and no extra stuff like their VPN or password manager. All of that and more comes only if you decide to invest in the full protection package, while the base malware protection layer is the same. This turns Bitdefender into a whole security system. It is designed not only to catch existing threats, but prevent new ones from ever reaching your device or doing damage to your data. For example, due to the ransomware remediation feature, you can upload your personal documents and files to the cloud and safeguard them from ransomware attacks. Meanwhile, the privacy firewall will watch your incoming and outgoing network traffic for any suspicious activities, which can prevent hacking attempts. There's also microphone and webcam protection for unauthorized access, as well as anti-phishing and anti-fraud tools. These block websites and emails that attempt to steal personal information. All of that amounts to a comprehensive security layer that makes your device an incredibly hard target for cyber criminals. And then you get some extra perks on top. For example, there are device optimization tools to improve performance and help save battery life. If you're looking to protect your kids, there are parental controls to monitor online activities. On top of that, there's a password manager for secure login storage and a VPN for private online browsing. Now, I'm not gonna lie, these last two are a bit lackluster compared to third-party apps. The VPN has a stupidly low data limit and the password manager is very basic, but if you want to try a whole cybersecurity package at once, it's still a good starting point. I also want to mention that iOS users can be a little disappointed in the Bitdefender app. It barely has any features, so I wouldn't recommend buying an antivirus just for an iOS specifically. What's more, keep in mind that the cheapest Bitdefender plan is Windows only. Since Windows users are the primary target of cybercriminals, it's a good thing for them. Not so much if you have a Mac, because you're then forced to buy a pricier plan. Mind you, it's still a really good investment, and it only sets you back like 20 bucks a year. Well, that's if you grab the discount deal in the description, otherwise it can cost you twice that. So make sure you check out those deals through the link in the description or just scan this handy dandy QR code right here. There's no need to overpay to have proper protection. Now, obviously, Bitdefender isn't your only option. For more advanced tech users out there, my best antivirus software recommendation is actually Norton. To me, Norton is like Bitdefender on steroids. This antivirus can be used on pretty much any operating system. And as for features, besides the numerous scans and solid real-time protection, where Norton really shines is their smart firewall. Compared to Bitdefender's counterpart, it's much more customizable, so you can be in charge of your own security. Another impressive feature here is heuristic analysis. It lets Norton make an educated guess and detect even zero-day threats based on suspicious patterns. Another cool feature is Genie scam protection. It uses AI to detect and warn you about suspicious texts, emails, and websites in real time. Of course, just like Bitdefender, Norton has a few extra tools up its sleeves, from a VPN and a password manager to parental controls. The thing is, I wouldn't recommend it as your very first antivirus unless you're comfortable with tech stuff overall. But for complete beginners, Norton can be a bit overwhelming. It used to be much worse, since in addition to tons of features and customization options, they also had a confusing interface. On the plus side, even the most basic Norton plan can protect any device that you want, be it PC or phone. However, Norton's main advantage is how extensive and customizable it is. So to reap the full benefits, I'd recommend investing in higher tier plans. These have more features and offer more secure cloud backup space. Plus, they protect more devices, so you get much better value overall. If you're still on the edge whether to get a free antivirus or a premium one, let me break it down. Free antivirus protection will only be enough against basic threats, but if you're very careful around the web, it might just be enough for you. Just be sure not to get a scammy version, it might end up being a free malware. Antivirus premium counterpart, however, is a much more powerful tool that will keep your device secure from all kinds of malicious threats. If you want a beginner-friendly option, choose Bitdefender. And for advanced users, I recommend Norton. Of course, it's up to you to decide where you want to invest your money. Here's one last tip though. Antiviruses often have steep renewal pricing. So if you really want to save a lot of money, just get one for a year and cancel the renewal. You can then just go back and grab it again with a new discount or try a new antivirus for a year. By then, I'll have a new updated review for you anyway. So don't forget to subscribe to the channel, stay updated, and thanks. I'll see you in the next one.